Hello everyone, welcome back to Wondershare Recoverit, the go-to solution for data recovery. And today we are thrilled to be able to show you the latest version, Recoverit 11. There are two big aspects to this latest version that we'll cover today, which are the enhanced recovery and the support for recovery of files on both NAS drives and Linux computers. And if you enjoyed this video and you want to see more like it in the future, then don't forget to click on the subscribe button and the notification bell. Enhanced recovery will perform a deep scan and a quick scan to find your lost photos and videos from all devices, including but not limited to SD cards, DJI, Canon, GoPro, Seagate, Sony, and so on. HD videos are often stored in multiple fragments within a camera or a storage device due to their large file sizes, so you may get frustrated when recovering fragmented videos using traditional video recovery tools. Recoverit's enhanced recovery feature scans, collects, and matches video fragments automatically to make sure that you get a complete video back. With this feature, you can efficiently and effectively recover HD, Ultra HD, 4K, and even 8K videos. Download and launch Wondershare Recoverit on your computer or laptop. Once done, go to the enhanced recovery option found on the left side of the main window. Here you will see a list of all external drives and hard drives. Choose the one that you wish to recover data from, and as soon as you enter the desired drive, Recoverit will ask you to choose the format that you want to scan for. By default, it will check the first two formats, i.e. MP4 and MOV. If you choose more file formats to scan for, then Recoverit will take longer to scan the device. Once you've chosen your desired format, hit the start button and Recoverit will begin performing a quick scan and a deep scan simultaneously. And you can see the progress for each at the bottom of the window. All of the files are scanned by the quick scan, which only renders the source files, such as individual fragments. By contrast, the deep scan takes a bit longer because it is looking for all of the different fragments and matching them together to make sure the complete video is restored. You can stop the scanning process at any time, even before it completes, once you've found your desired files. And once the scanning is complete, it's always better to preview your photos and videos first before you recover them. This ensures that you're going to recover the stuff that you actually need. Simply take your cursor onto the thumbnail for a particular file and press the preview button and you will be able to see the video or photo you want to restore. You can preview as many photos as you want or you can see a 30-second clip for each video. Once you're sure that you've previewed the right photo or video, it's time to press the recover button. Doing this will open a new window on your screen where you can choose the location to save the recovered photo or video to on your laptop or computer. And we'd recommend that you choose a different path to save the recovered data to compared to where it was lost from. NAS drives, or network attached storage, are essentially like an external hard drive that you access over a network rather than having it plugged directly into your computer. And Linux is an operating system, much like Windows or Mac OS. Both of these are susceptible to data loss, to things like malware infection, power failure, OS errors, overheating, and accidental deletion. But the all-new NAS and Linux recovery features help you overcome these problems. The NAS recovery feature allows you to remotely cover data without having to unplug any NAS hard drives, and it is highly compatible with iOmega Store Center, Lacey, QNAP, Netgear's ReadyNAS, Western Digital, and other similar NAS devices. As before, launch Recoverit and go to the left bar on the main interface. Look for the NAS and Linux option and enter this mode. Next, tap on the NAS recovery button at the bottom of the Recoverit window, and Recoverit will scan for any detectable NAS drives. These will then be displayed under the NAS server section. Tap on the NAS device that you want to recover from. It's best to make sure the SSH service is enabled at this point. Now provide your IP and port along with your user account and password to remotely connect your NAS device. After providing the requested information, click the Connect button to proceed. Once a connection has been established, an automatic scan will be enabled to search for lost data on that selected NAS device. As with the enhanced recovery that we covered earlier, you can monitor the progress of the scan, stop it at any time, and preview your files before proceeding with the recovery. And all of these steps remain the same regardless of whether you are doing this on a Windows computer or on a Mac. Whilst Linux is an incredible operating system for professionals, as mentioned earlier, it is still vulnerable to data loss. The new Linux recovery feature is an efficient recovery tool that ensures precise recovery of Linux data files and offers great support for the ext4 file system. The steps for recovery here are very similar to those previously covered modes. After opening Recoverit on either your Mac or your Windows computer, go to the NAS and Linux option from the left panel, but this time press on the Linux recovery button. Now we will establish a remote connection to our Linux device, so please make sure the SSH service is enabled. Input the IP address, port, user account, and password in the respective sections and press the connect button in the bottom right corner. Wait until a connection is successfully established. Once done, automatic scanning will be started to find data files that you've lost. Again, wait until the program finds the deleted or lost files, following which you can stop the scan if you wish and preview the data files before you recover them. And that concludes our in-depth look into the new features of Recoverit version 11. We hope you've enjoyed watching, and please don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you haven't already done so that you never miss out on any new videos.